Hey, welcome back to the Mr. Excel Netcast. I'm Bill Jones.
Basically, you start out with massive amounts of data. You say, how are we going to analyze this? Well, let's fire up a pivot table and see if we can solve this problem.
Hey, welcome back to the Mr. Excel Netcast, episode number 952, February 17th. It's my birthday today. All right. Hey, great tip today. I learned this tip when I was doing a seminar in Madison, Wisconsin. Laura was there and gave this great navigation tip, although I want to talk first about how to jump to the end of a spreadsheet or end of a data range, actually. Now, going back to the days of Lotus 1-2-3, you could use the end key, END, press the end key and then press any arrow key. I'll press end and then down arrow. And you see that I jump from cell A1 down to the edge of the data set. And similarly, if I'm somewhere in the middle, I press end right, I'll get to the right edge. And then I can press end and the right arrow again to jump the gap and end up at the next data set. So this is a great way to very quickly get to the last row. Now, the gotcha here is that if there's a blank cell, it stops at the blank. So end and down will stop right before that blank cell. Now, for the people who started in Excel instead of Lotus, you might use the control and the down arrow key. So control down arrow is like pressing end down, control up arrow, control right, control left. And those will also jump the gap. So control right arrow gets me to the right edge. Control right arrow will jump the gap. Now, here is Laura's trick. Laura said, did you know that if you double click any edge of the current cell, it will do the same thing? So if you're a mouse person, you now have a great way to replicate this keyboard navigation. So if I double click on the bottom, it will jump down to the end. If I double click on the right, it'll jump to the right edge. Double click on the left, it will jump to the left edge. I thought that was so cool. I always love when there's some great little navigation trick that I haven't discovered and someone in one of my seminars shows me. Now, the one difference with this, if I'm at the right edge of the data and I control click on the edge, it takes me to right before the data instead of actually jumping to the cell. Control down arrow would have taken me to column I. In this case, it doesn't. Now, you know, interesting thing here. So I learned something new and, you know, that became my Facebook status. Hey, did you know if you double click the bottom edge, you know, it will do this? And Greg Truby pops in first and Greg says, well, he's such a keyboard person, he never would have discovered that. But then two other folks, Beth Melton and Gary Whiteford, both were unhappy with this because they miss double clicking the fill handle and hit the bottom edge, and for them it's a very frustrating thing. So you know, Gary said, it'd be nice if I could just shut off this feature. So for me, I thought a great new way, fast way to get to the bottom of the data set, especially if your hand's already on the mouse, a good way to go, although Beth and Gary pointing out that it is a little bit annoying when it does it and you didn't expect it to do it. So try that out. Thanks to Laura from, I think, Waukesha, Wisconsin, for that cool Excel tip. Catch you next time for another Netcast from Mr. Excel.
Well, thanks for stopping by. We'll see you next time for another Netcast from Mr. Excel.